Hallelujah. Into death, so that as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live a new life. For if we have been united with him in a death like his, we shall certainly be united with him in a resurrection like his. Please stand.
Thank you.
Let us pray. O God of grace and glory, we remember before you today our brother Kenneth Ray Ingstead. We thank you for giving him to us to know and to love as a companion in our pilgrimage on earth. In your boundless compassion, console us who mourn. Give us your aid so we may see in death the gate to eternal life, that we may continue our course on earth in confidence until, by your call, we are reunited with those who have gone before us. Through your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
As we gather to worship God today, we turn to His Word for words of hope, comfort, and joy. The first lesson from the prophet Isaiah, the 40th chapter. A voice says, "Cry out!" And I said, "What shall I cry?" All people are grass. Their constancy is like the flower of the field. The grass withers, the flower fades when the breath of the Lord blows upon it. Surely the people are grass. The grass withers, the flower fades, but the word of our God will stand forever. The psalm for today, Psalm 121, which we will read responsibly. I lift up my eyes to the hills. From where will my help come?
My help comes from the Lord, who made heaven and earth.
He will not let your foot be moved. He who keeps you will not slumber.
He who keeps Israel will neither slumber nor sleep.
The Lord is your keeper. The Lord is your shade at your right hand.
The sun shall not strike you by day, nor the moon by night.
The Lord will keep you from all evil. He will keep your life.
The Lord will keep your going out and your coming in from this time on and forevermore.
A lesson from Paul's first letter to the Corinthians, the 13th chapter. Love never ends, but as for prophecies, they will come to an end. As for tongues, they will cease. As for knowledge, it will come to an end. For we know only in part, and we prophesy only in part. But when the complete comes, the partial will come to an end. When I was a child, I spoke like a child. I thought like a child. I reasoned like a child. When I became an adult, I put an end to childish ways. For now, we see only a reflection, as in a mirror. But then, we will see face to face. Now, I know only in part. Then I will know fully, even as I have been fully known. And now faith, hope, and love remain. These three, and the greatest of these is love. Here ends the reading. Please stand for the gospel affirmation. Hallelujah. Jesus Christ, the firstborn of the dead, to him be glory and power forever and ever. Amen.
Alleluia.
Our Holy Gospel lesson according to St. John, the 14th chapter. Jesus speaks, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also. And you know the way to the place where I am going." Thomas said to him, "Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." This is the gospel of the Lord. On behalf of the congregation, I wish you condolences. Carla, Ronnie, Bobby, JJ, Cherie, and the rest of the family and friends on the death of your brother, uncle, and our Christian brother, Kenneth. We pray that you will know the presence, peace, and hope of Jesus Christ in the days to come. Know those in the congregation, and know that those that know that the congregation and those gathered here will be keeping you in our thoughts and prayers. We gather today with sadness and a sense of loss. Even though we witnessed Kenny declining, particularly over the last 3 years or so, with his need for dialysis and his other health problems, the end of Kenny's life seemed to come quite suddenly. Thank you for your care and walking with him during this time, particularly you, Carla. In the midst of sorrow and loss, though, there are many good memories and stories of Drake, and I appreciate that you as family shared some of those with me and with us all through the obituary that you wrote. While we cannot tell them all in these few minutes, I hope that you will continue to share memories in the days and the years to come. The first time I met with Kenny, I knew that he had a rodeo arena. And so I asked him about that. As you shared in the obituary, rodeo was a part of his life, both as a participant as well as a support for the sport. He talked with pride that day about his involvement, teaching and supporting youth in these rodeo activities, and I could tell it was an important part of his life. You spoke of his interest in other sports, particularly basketball and football, and his love of Super Bowl Sundays. There was another love of his you told me of as well, crying rib on Christmas. And there were humorous stories as well. Bobby told me about Kenny getting a deal on tires and hauling them in the back of his Bluebell truck, and you had to help unload them. Of playing the snowball game with the entire family this past Christmas. And I see you left some snowballs for him to play with in the meantime. Then there was the time he bought 15 pies at Waterburger, and you had to wait a long time for them to get ready. Vicki Klecker told me of the time Drake said his eye came out, rolled across the room, and he had to retrieve it. She asked him, "How did you get it back in?" He said, "Well, I just popped it back in." You believe that? He also told me how he would tell the kids he lost his toe, and could they help him find it back? Even at the end, the stories kept coming. Bobby, you told me he had commented about his ambulance ride from Bryan to Houston, that he got to go to Houston because they had to deliver a pig, and that the ambulance was a mess. And then he topped it off by saying he wanted to tell them that the pig wasn't big enough to process, but he figured that was none of his business. In true brother-sister fashion, Carlin, you told me he was full of BS and stories and that he liked to aggravate all of us. You also shared that Kenny loved kids, particularly his nieces and great-niece and great-nephew. This was confirmed when Kenny told me that Ronnie and Deborah had brought Adeline when you visited him in the hospital in Houston, and how much she lifted his spirits. And I know, Bobby, that it was meaningful that Kenny was a part of your girls' lives and that you and your girls were with Kenny when he died. But reality being reality, it was not all joking and funny, particularly toward the end. We all saw Kenneth declining in vigor, strength, and health over these past 3 years, and particularly in his last days. This decline that we experienced walking with him led me to choose a lesson from Isaiah that we read. Hear those words, some of them again. All people are grass. Their constancy is like the flower of the field. The grass withers, the flower fades, but the word of our God will stand forever. Kenny knew he was declining as well. When I was visiting him in the hospital in Bryan and he was suffering a great deal, he told me, "I think the end is near." That gave us a chance to talk about the end of his life on earth. I asked if he was ready for death. In summary, he said he was, though he was not in a hurry for it. But he certainly did not want to have to go through the pain he was experiencing again. We talked about his funeral. He told me not to worry about any particulars, but to make the words right. And then he told me to tell you that his death was a blessing in disguise. He wanted you to know that. His suffering and struggle would be over and done. Indeed, withering and fading is not the end, because God's word of promise of eternal life through the death and resurrection of Jesus will stand forever. When I visited him in Cruzy, Kenneth shared a dream he had with me. He told me he was walking along a path and he thought it was on the way to heaven. He said to the left of the path he was on was a group of people at a gate. He said they were yelling and screaming, trying to get in, but someone was there keeping the gate shut, not letting them in. He didn't know who was keeping them out, but he said the yelling and screaming was horrible. I was reminded of Jesus' words in Matthew 7 when Kenny was sharing this with me. There Jesus says, "Not everyone who says to me, 'Lord, Lord,' will enter the kingdom of heaven, but only the one who does the will of my Father in heaven." You see, there will be some who know about Jesus and think that that is enough, even though they are not living with Jesus as Lord and Savior. They know about Jesus, but they do not know Jesus. There's a difference. And Jesus answered them with some sad words. Because they did not take time to worship or live with Jesus, Jesus says, "I never knew you." I think this is who Kenneth may have heard in his dream. Another thing Kenneth saw in the dream was a pond of water. But he says it was surrounded by thorny plants so that no one could get to the water. And finally, as he kept walking, he saw a man who he thought was Jesus standing on the path. And just as the man opened and stretched out his arms, Kenneth woke up. I remember that story of the dream as I thought about it today. And I thought of Jesus' words in our gospel text. "In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, so that where I am, you may be also." When I last saw Kenneth in the hospital in Houston, I told him, "Next time you see him, go with him." So he laughed and said he would. After all, it seems he had prepared a place for Kenny and was inviting him home to the place he had prepared. It's difficult to understand why Kenneth had to experience decline in his later life. We will pray in a few minutes that we be kept faithful in God's promises, even in the midst of things we cannot understand. St. Paul said it well in our lesson, "For now we see only a reflection, as in a mirror." Some translations say we see in a mirror dimly. It was that way for Kenneth in his dream. He saw part of the picture. It is that way for us. We see a reflection dimly for now. But St. Paul goes on to say, but then we will see face to face. Now I know only in part, then I will know fully, even as I have been fully known. We place Kenneth today in the hands of the Savior, Jesus, who died for him on the cross and who was raised from death to eternal life. We worship and give thanks to God for Kenneth's life and for God's promises that are his through Jesus Christ. This Savior Jesus promises his eternal life to all who believe and live in him. He has gone to prepare a place for Kenneth and for all his faithful people. Let us be thankful for the special things we remember about Drake and the life we shared with him. Let us commend him today into the hands of his loving God, who sustained him in life and who died for him that he might know eternal life, and who is able to care for him for eternity, where he has no more pain, no more weakness, no more infirmity. And let us continue our lives. Let us live in Jesus, committing ourselves to live faithfully as his disciples, so that one day we will join Kenneth and all the saints around the throne of God, living through Jesus Christ. Thanks be to our loving and gracious God. Amen. Together in trust and hope, we confess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty God, you have knit your chosen people together in one communion, in the mystical body of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Give to your whole church in heaven and on earth your light and your peace.
Hear us, Lord.
Grant that all who have been baptized into Christ's death and resurrection may die to sin and rise to newness of life, and that through the grave and gate of death we may pass with him to our joyful resurrection.
Hear us, Lord.
Grant to us, who are still in our pilgrimage and who walk as yet by faith, that your Holy Spirit may lead us in holiness and righteousness all our days.
Hear us, Lord.
Grant to your faithful people pardon and peace, that we may be cleansed from all our sins and serve you with a quiet mind.
Hear us, Lord.
Grant to all who mourn a sure confidence in your loving care, that, casting all their sorrow on you, they may know the consolation of your love.
Hear us, Lord.
Give courage and faith to those who are bereaved, that they may have strength to meet the days ahead in the comfort of a holy and certain hope, and in the joyful expectation of eternal life with those they love.
Hear us, Lord.
Help us, we pray, in the midst of things we cannot understand, to believe and trust in the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection to life everlasting.
Hear us, Lord.
Grant us grace to entrust Kenneth Ray Neenstedt to your never-failing love, which sustained him in this life. Receive him into the arms of your mercy, and remember him according to the favor you bear for your people.
Hear us, Lord.
God of grace, you sent your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, to bring life and immortality to light. We give you thanks because by his death, Jesus destroyed the power of death, and by his resurrection has opened the kingdom of heaven to all believers. Make us certain that because he lives, we shall live also, and that neither death nor life, nor things present nor things to come, shall be able to separate us from your love, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Into your hands, O merciful Savior, we commend your servant, Kenneth Ray Neenstedt. Acknowledge, we humbly beseech you, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, a sinner of your own redeeming. Receive him into the arms of your mercy and into the blessed rest of everlasting peace
and into the glorious
company of the saints in life.
Amen.
Let us go forth in peace.
In the name of Christ. Amen.